to that.
Yeah, he said that the only role for a new domain name is if you're making something that's socially different, such as .org. He said, you know, the .org name was interesting because it captures the fact that you know the website you're visiting with that suffix is a non-profit. And so you kind of have a better understanding of what the site is by looking at it, whereas just having .cameras or, you know, .horses or .pugs, you don't actually know who owns that website and what it's about necessarily.
Definitely.
I mean, you might know it's about pugs, but you don't know who the owner of it is.
Yeah, .gov is always really useful because you know it's a government website, or .edu being an educational resource is really useful.
And he said this is kind of forcing companies to register their trademarks in different places and at vast expense, as we've said in previous podcasts, it's $185,000.
Awesome, thanks, Liv. I know we've got some stories on the website already. I think if you search W3C, Tim Berners-Lee,
Tim.
We'll get back to the source in your inbox. Anyway, we've got a couple more stories to get to on today's show. Teller of Penn & Teller fame is suing a Dutch magician for copyright infringement. It's a landmark case for magicians because it revolves around Teller's trick, which is called shadows. Have you seen that?
I don't think I have seen it, no.
It's the one where he cuts the shadow off a rose but causes the petals on the real rose that's casting the shadow to actually fall off.
Okay, so he snips a shadow with scissors and the real petals fall off.
Yeah, that's it. He's been doing it for 35 years, apparently, which I didn't know, and he obtained a copyright registration for it in 1983. But this Dutch magician called Gerard Dog, well, it's probably not pronounced Dog. How would you pronounce that?
Doer?
Okay.
I mean, it's spelled Dogger. Well, we can get around that, can we?
The Dutch magician called Gerard posted a video of himself performing an illusion called The Rose and Her Shadow to YouTube, which he described as a version of, quote, the great Penn and Teller performing a similar trick. And he offered, this is the bad bit, he offered to reveal how the trick was done for just over $2,000 in UK pounds.
I think we can probably use the Dutch magician's stage name, which is Gerard Bacardi.
Okay.
That's easier than pronouncing Dogger. Dogger.
It is a bit. Now, Teller, just to put another twist in the story, Teller himself offered the money for this chap not to reveal the secret, but no agreement could be agreed upon. So Teller has now filed a lawsuit in the USA over the video, which could help determine the level of protection that stage magicians actually have over their tricks, which is why it's such an interesting case.
Okay, so what is he actually copywriting here? Because surely you can't just copyright the mechanics of a trick.
It's a little bit, I think, like protecting a script for a play, as opposed to, you know, the play itself.
So you're kind of like protecting the stuff that surrounds the actual trick, because you can't protect the trick, because if you do that, you have to explain how it works.
Yeah.
I think what's going to be interesting to see is how the court sort of views it, whether they judge, you know, if you do it in an entirely different circumstance, if you didn't use a rose, and I know in the past you did use a rose, if you didn't use a rose and instead used, I don't know, a daisy or something like that, would that still count as a trick? Possibly not, even though you'd be doing essentially the same trick.
I'm kind of interested by the fact that Teller got in touch with this guy and said, I'll give you money to not reveal and not sell how this trick is done. And, you know, there was a guy, I think, was it a guy from the darkness, late 90s, early 2000s, who tried to buy a physical copy of a leaked version of an upcoming album from the guy in there, or something like that. I'm protected from being leaked. Anyway, digressing. We've got one more quick story to get to, which is that a building capable of housing 700 people is being built to replace a 131-year-old...